Okay, the Norton's theorem. So the Norton's theorem is nothing but a dual of Thevenin's theorem. In Thevenin's theorem, voltage source in series with the resistor, na, across the load. But here, current source in parallel with the in parallel to the resistor. Okay, current source in parallel with the Norton's resistance is called Norton's theorem. Okay, Norton's theorem is an analytical method used to change the complex circuit into a simple equivalent circuit consisting of single resistance in parallel with the current source. Single resistor, that is called Norton's resistance in parallel with current source. So it is looks like a practical current source. Na, Thevenin's theorem, it looks like a practical voltage source. Voltage source, practical voltage source is a voltage source in series with the resistor in practical current source. Current source in parallel with the resistor, no? So like this, across the load. Okay. So Thevenin's theorem is the source. If you are applying the source transformation to the Thevenin's theorem, that will become Norton's theorem. Okay. So by applying the source transformation to the Thevenin's theorem, you will get Norton's theorem, Norton's equivalent circuit. Okay. If you are applied source transformation to the Thevenin's circuit, equivalent circuit, then you will get a Norton's equivalent circuit. The Thevenin's theorem and Norton's theorem, these two are dual. Okay. Duality of each other. So statement, Thevenin's Norton's theorem statement, at any linear circuit containing several energy sources and resistance and can be replaced by a single current generator, okay, in parallel with the single resistor is called a Norton's theorem. Okay, this Norton's theorem is also applicable for linear circuits only, not applicable for non-linear circuits. Okay, as far as the low resistance RL is connected in single resistance RN concerned, the single resistance, okay, RN is the value of resistance looking back into the network with the all the current sources open circuited and all current sources are open circuited, all voltage sources are short circuited. And if the short circuit current at the output terminal shown below, so you can easily understand. So by removing the load, we are finding the voltage across this removing the load. That is called VTH, na, Thevenin's voltage. But here different. By short circuit, by removing the load, so we have to short circuit the two terminals. That is called Norton's current. Okay, so this is called Norton's equivalent circuit. This is a linear network containing several energy sources, resistance. This is called load. So A and B, the terminals, so this is called load. So any circuit, this linear network can be converted into a single current source, okay, in parallel with one resistor. That is called Norton's resistance across the load. This is called Norton's theorem, equivalent circuit. Okay. So the value of this constant current is one which would flow if the two output terminals were short-circuited, shorted together, while Norton's resistance should be measured looking back into the terminals. So to find the Norton's resistance means, so voltage sources are short-circuited, I mean, so internal resistance of the voltage source is zero. That's why by replacing the internal resistance of the sources, so we will find the Norton's resistance, same as Thevenin's resistance. Okay, Thevenin's resistance procedure, Norton's resistance procedure, same. Okay, but Thevenin's voltage here, instead of Thevenin's voltage, we are finding Norton's current. The Norton's current is nothing but short circuit current. Okay, by removing the load, so we have to short circuit the A and B terminal, and we have to find the current flowing through this. Okay, short circuit terminal, understood. So the basic procedure for solving the circuit using Norton's theorem as follows. Okay, yesterday I was explained how to find the Thevenin's, what are the steps involved in the Thevenin's theorem. So same as here also for Norton's theorem. So basic procedure for solving the circuit using Norton's theorem. Remove the low resistance RL or component concern. This is called low resistance RL. Remove the load, same as Thevenin's theorem here also. Remove the load resistance RL. and find the RN by shorting the voltage sources or by opening the current all current sources. You know well, voltage sources are short circuited, current sources are open circuit. By using that concept to find the resistance between A and B terminals, that is called Norton's resistance. Okay, otherwise Thevenin's resistance. Thevenin's resistance or Norton's resistance, both are same. There is no changes. Okay, but only indication. So Norton's resistance indicated by RN, Thevenin's resistance indicated by RTH. Understood. So find IN by using, find IN by placing a shorting link on the output terminals A and B. Okay. So find IN. So by shorting these two terminals like this. Okay. By shorting these two terminals, find the that current. Current flowing into this shorting terminal. Okay. Current flowing into the shorting terminal. So that is called Norton's current, that is called short circuit current. Find IN by placing a shorting the link on the output terminals A and B. Find the current flow through the low resistance RL. Okay, this is called Norton's theorem. Okay, and then you can easily understand by using another concept same as yesterday. This is called one of the concept related to the Norton's theorem. So how to this here in detail explanation is there in this PDF. Okay, so how to find the Norton's equivalent circuit by using Norton's theorem concept. So Norton's theorem states that, so this complete information about the, so definition means a complete information about the Norton's equivalent circuit, Norton's theorem in this statement. Norton's theorem state that any two terminals A and B, any two terminals A and B of a network is composed of linear resistances. Okay, so like this complicated linear network is okay, and independent sources, that is called voltage or current or combination of voltage and current sources. Okay, may be replaced by equivalent current sources and a parallel resistance. Equivalent current source in parallel with resistance. Am I right? So like this. Equivalent current source and parallel with resistance. So like this. Understood? So the magnitude of the current source is the current measured in the short circuit placed across the terminals A and B. The magnitude of the current source is the current measured is in the short circuited placed across the terminals A and B by placing the short circuit terminal. That means by removing the load, and we have to short circuit these terminals, and then we have to find that short circuit current. Okay, that is called Norton's current. And the parallel resistance is equivalent to a parallel resistance, that is called RN, Norton's resistance, is looking into the terminals A and B, same as Thevenin's resistance. With all independent sources have been replaced by their internal resistance. That means voltage sources, short circuited, and current sources, open circuit. Understood? In any linear circuit, no matter how complicated, can also be replaced by an equivalent circuit consisting of DC current source in parallel with one resistance. Okay. So Norton's theorem is a dual of Thevenin's theorem. I'm already explained. Norton's theorem is a dual of Thevenin's theorem. To find the current IL through a load resistance RL using Norton's theorem, the following steps are followed. Okay. Simple steps are there. By using this step, so we can easily find the Norton's equivalent circuit. This is called step one. Okay. Short the output terminals after disconnecting the load resistance. So disconnect this load resistance and short the output terminals, that will become IN. Okay. And remove the load resistance RL from the terminals A and B. Calculate the short circuit current IN. Okay, in this short circuit terminals, find the current IN. Okay, in general, one can apply techniques. You know, well, mesh analysis or nodal analysis or superposition theory, any one method. By using that method, so find the current flowing through this. Okay. And I learned in earlier lessons to compute IN and experimentally just measure the short circuit current. Okay, so you know well how to find this Norton's resistance by using mesh analysis or by using nodal analysis or by using superposition theorem. So which method is easy? So mesh analysis or nodal analysis or superposition. Okay, if you are easy, nodal analysis, follow the nodal analysis. Okay, someone is easy, mesh analysis. Okay, follow the mesh analysis. Okay, it's not fixed. Use mesh analysis or use node analysis. Use any one method, but the result is same. Okay, must follow the one any one method, and you can get the result. That result must be same. Okay, this is called short circuit terminals complete. And step two, redraw the circuit with each practical sources replaced by internal resistance, while short circuits across the output terminals removed. Okay, voltage source should be short circuited and just replace the plain wire, and current source should be open circuited. Okay, just remove. Look back into the resulting circuit and from the load terminals, so like this. So nothing is simple. So what is the procedure followed in Thevenin's theorem? Here also same procedure for Norton's resistance. Okay, with all voltage sources are circuited and current sources open circuited, and by doing like that, the circuit will become is a combination of resistance, that means series and parallel, or star to delta and delta to star. Okay, that is the method. So to find the delta to stars. Okay, so this is the method. This is the procedure how to find this resistance. Okay, that is called Norton's resistance. Okay, Norton's resistance, and see here, Norton's resistance Rn is truly same as that of Thevenin's resistance Rn is circuit. Norton's resistance and the Thevenin's resistance, both procedure is same. That's why. So only names are different. Here Norton's and here Thevenin's. Okay, and the last and but one step that is called place Rn in parallel with the current source. That is called IN. Norton's equivalent circuit is replacing imaginary fencing port like this portion, or a fixed part of the circuit with an equivalent partial current source. So like this. Okay, current source in parallel with the resistor. And reconnect the original load. So like this, A and B, reconnect the original loads and to the original load and to the Norton's current circuit. The load voltage, current and power may be calculated by simply arithmetic operations only. Understood? This is, IL is equal to this current division rule. This current is equal to total current into opposite resistor by some of the resistance. This current is equal to total current into opposite resistance by some of the resistors. And voltage across the load, VL is equal to voltage across the load, VL is equal to IL into RL. Power across the load, power observed by load, VL is equal to IL square into RL. You know well, these are the relations, one simple arithmetic relations. Same as Thevenin's theorem, here also Norton's theorem, similar advantages. So by using mesh analysis, node analysis, or superposition theorem, has required so many equations. But in Norton's theorem, so only one equivalent circuit, that is called Norton's current and Norton's resistance. Okay, so to find the current. So that means even though if the load changes, it is easily find the power absorbed by the load. Okay, this is the components. Norton's currents, so this is the some information about the currents, Norton's theorem. And so one example, application of Norton's theorem. Try to construct, you can easily understand this Norton's theorem. Okay, by using this one problem. So application of Norton's theorem. So for the circuit, find IAB by using Norton's theorem. Current through the load resistor. This is called load resistor RL. Okay, find the current flowing through the RL by using Norton's theorem. For the circuit shown in figure 8.10 here. So this is the circuit. Find the current through the RL is equal to R2 is equal to 1 ohm resistor. This is called load resistor. That is called IAB branch using Norton's theorem. Okay, so this is the one example for Norton's theorem. So, and then so calculate the voltage across the current source also. So voltage across the current source. One more question is asked here. Okay, ENCG, VCG, the voltage across the VCG also. But our main concept is how to find the current flowing into the this branch. Find the current flowing into the load resistor, that is called R, by using Norton's theorem. Okay, steps. So first one, what is the first one? Remove the load. No? Remove the resistor through which the current to be found, and short the terminals A and B. Okay, in Thevenin's theorem, so by remove the load and open circuiting this A and B terminals in Thevenin's theorem. But here different. Norton's theorem is different. By removing the load, and we have to short circuit the terminals A and B, and then we are finding the current AB. Okay, like this. Okay, just remove this load. Remove this load, A and B, and remove this load, and then short circuit the terminals, A and B terminals, and then we will get Norton's equivalent Norton's current. Okay, so this is called the current flowing through the A and B terminals is called Norton's current. Short circuit terminal. This is called short circuit terminal. Here load resistor is there. Now you are asking what is the question here? Find the current flowing through the load resistor RL is equal R2 is equal 1 ohm resistor. Na? Okay, this by removing this load, short circuit this terminal, and this is called this current flowing through A and B is called Norton's currents by using mesh analysis. So find the current flowing through the so A and B. So here I3, so I1, the mesh I1, mesh I2, and mesh I3. So what is the Norton's current here? Norton's current is nothing but I1 minus I3. Am I right? This current is in this direction, clockwise direction. This current is opposite direction. That's why what is the current here? So I1 minus I3 is equal to IN. Next, any method can be adapted to compute the current flowing through the A and B. So here, instead of using nodal mesh analysis, you want to follow the nodal analysis. Okay, we'll get the same answer. If you want to follow the superposition theorem, then we'll get to the answers by activating this source and deactivating this source and the current I1. Okay, and similarly by deactivating this source and activating this source, find the current I2 and find the resultant current I1 plus I2. That is called superposition theorem. According to the superposition theorem, if you want to find, okay, you will get the same result. Otherwise, if you follow the mesh analysis. So better way to apply mesh analysis compared to superposition theorem and nodal analysis. So all of you prepare. So mesh analysis is one of the powerful technique compared to nodal analysis and superposition theorem. So you will get the exactly results, and complicated circuits also you will get the results very easily by using mesh analysis compared to nodal and compared to superposition theorem. Any method can be adapted, but all of you prefer mesh analysis. Okay, so understood. So here by applying the mesh analysis, so here what is the mesh here 3. Okay, and here there is no resistor, no? That is why there is no voltage drop here, and here minus R4 into I1 minus I2 is equal to 0. Okay, and here I2 is called mesh current and this is called branch current. So here this branch current is equal to mesh current because of this not interlinking with another meshes. That's why I2 is equal to minus 2. I2 downwards direction, this cut to currents upward direction. That's why I2 is equal to minus 2. And then so by simplifying, you will get I2 is equal to, like this. Substitute here, I2 is equal in this equation, you will get I1. So what is the R4? Your 2 ohms resistor. So by substituting this, we get I1 is equal to minus 0.5 amps. In loop 3, so here, what is the current? R1 into I3, minus R1 into I3. What is the voltage drop here? Minus R1 into I3. Here also minus R3 into I3 minus I2. Here there is no resistance, 0. That's why there is no voltage drop. Is equal to 0. Substitute I2, you know, well, I2 is known. And only unknown thing is I3. So we'll get I3 minus side by side. Okay, then Norton's current IN is equal to nothing but I1 minus I3. This is I1 direction, Norton's current direction, both are same. Na? This is called Norton's current direction, this is called I1 direction. So this is opposite direction. That's why I1 minus I3. IN is equal to not I1 minus I3. So in this way, we'll get, you know, I1, you know, I3, substitute here, and then we'll get Norton's current. Current flowing through the branch A to B. So like this. Okay, then step 3, so to compute the, this is called Norton's current. Norton's current is over. That means same as Thevenin's theorem, VTH is, okay, by opening the circuit, by opening this circuit, so we have to find the open circuit voltage. Same we are also, by short circuit in this terminal, we have to find the Norton's current. That is called short circuit current or Norton's current. Understood, this is called Norton's current. The step 3, so same procedure for Thevenin's theorem and Norton's theorem. Same procedure to find the Norton's resistance and Thevenin's resistance. You have to compute R, and all sources are replaced by the internal resistance. That is means voltage source and current sources are replaced by their internal resistance. Voltage source internal resistance 0, that's a short circuit. Current source internal resistance is infinity, that's why it's open circuit. By doing like that, so find the current, find the resistance looking terminals A and B. The current source internal resistance is infinity, na? That's why it is open circuited. Okay. Internal resistance of the current source is infinity, that's why it's open circuit. and internal resistance of the voltage source is zero, that's why it is short circuit. And then, so what is the resistance between these two A and terminals? A and B terminals is nothing but RAB, that is called Norton's resistance. Okay, so these two become this circuit, and here try to consider this is a 4 ohm resistor. No current is dividing flowing in this direction because of open circuit. So this current flowing in this direction and this current is flowing in this direction. Okay, that's why this current is not dividing this junction. Current is flowing in this direction and like this in this direction. Current is flowing in this direction. Okay, 4 ohm resistor and 3 ohm resistor. Current is goes like this. Okay, that means current is not dividing, means it these two are series, 4+3. This is called 7 ohm resistor, and then this is called 2 ohm resistor. Here, the one terminal of this branch is connected one in here, and one terminal is connected here. And this branch, one terminal is connected here, and this terminal is connected here. And that means 2 ohm resistor and 3+4, 7 ohm resistor, 2 ohm resistor, and 7 ohm resistors are parallel. Okay, and then you will get an equivalent resistance. Yeah, that is called Norton's resistance. Rn is equal 1.55. Understood? Replace the original circuit with this Norton's equivalent circuit is like this. So this is called Norton's current. You know well. So from here, 9/14 is called Norton's current in this direction, and Norton's resistance. So from here, these two are 4 ohm resistor and 3 ohm resistors are series. That will become 7 and 7 parallel with 2. And you will get 1.55 ohms. Current source is connected in parallel with the resistor. Na? That is called Norton's theorem. And connect reconnect the load. So like this, man. RL is equal to 1 ohm, so reconnect the load. And by using this theorem, so you can easily find the Norton's current. So how the load current is nothing but total current into opposite resistor by sum of the resistors. The load current is equal to IL is equal to total current, that is called 0.643. This is called 643, na? Yes, 0.643 total current to opposite resistor is nothing but 1.55 by some of the resistance. 1.55 plus 1 is equal to 0.39 amps A to B. Okay, so in this way, we have to find the current flowing through the low resistor by using Norton's theorem. Understood? And this is the current flowing through the low resistor. How much here? 0.39. This is the current flowing through the low resistor, 0.39. So this is about Norton's circuit. So assignment for you: find VCG, the voltage across this current source. Okay, find the voltage across the current source. Understood this problem? For this circuit. Okay, find the current flowing through the find IL. By using Norton's theorem. Understood? All of you do this problem. Calculate current flowing through the load by using Norton's theorem. First, so what is the position? First, to remove the load. Okay. And do the short circuit. And then find the current IN, that is called Norton's current. Find the Norton's current, short circuit current. So that is called first IN. IN. How to find IN, Norton's current? Okay, Norton's current. So remove the load, redraw the circuit, plus minus your resistor, 2 ohms. 4 ohm here, 3 ohms. So 2 ohms here, and 3 ohms here, and 4 ohms here. Okay. So like this. So what is the voltage here? 30 volts. So A and B terminals are short circuit. Na? So by removing the load, short circuit like this. This current is called Norton's current. Am I right? This current is not called Norton's current, short circuit. Also called as a short circuit current. Also called as here AB now, AB terminals. Okay, IAB. is also called as IAB. Understood. So not as current or a short circuit current or current flowing to the ENB terminals is also called as Norton's current. Follow any one method, you can get the Norton's current. Okay. So just a simple circuit, no? That's why I'm using a node analysis. Okay. So I'm taking here one OP. So V minus, so 30 divided by 2. So in this direction, so the, what is this current? V by 4. So in this direction, and V by 3 in this direction. Okay, this is equal to 0. Find the V. Find V. V is equal to 13.846, na? And what is the Norton's current here? What is the Norton's current? What is the Norton's current here? So this current, the current is nothing but current flowing through 3 ohm resistor is called Norton's current. Na? This current is called Norton's current. That means V by 3. What is the voltage here? V by 3 is called Norton's current. IN is equal to V by 3. So V is nothing but 13.846. So divided by 3. So we'll get 4.61. Good. So this is called Norton's current, 4.6. Similarly, find Norton's resistance. Similarly, find Norton's resistance by short circuiting the voltage source and find the resistance. So Norton's current is over, and then find the Norton's resistance. That is called same procedure for Thevenin's, same as Thevenin's theorem. Voltage source is short circuited and do the calculations. Same. So redraw the circuit. Here voltage source is short circuit. So there 2 ohm resistor and 4 ohm resistor, and this called 3 ohm resistor, and find this in between these two. So here A and B, na? So find the resistance, that is called Norton's resistance here. So 2 ohm, 4 ohm and 3 ohms. So here Norton's resistance Rn is equal to 2 ohm resistor and 4 ohm resistors are parallel, okay, and in series with 3 ohm resistor. This is called Norton's resistance. So tell me how much here. 2 into 4 divided by 2 plus 4, 4 by 3 plus 3, 4.33. So I got 4.33 ohms. Is it right or not? This is called Norton's resistance. Okay. And draw the circuit, Norton's equivalent circuit, and find the current flowing through. So what is the Norton's equivalent circuit here? Current source in parallel with the resistor, na? Current source in parallel with the resistor. So this is called Norton's current, and in parallel with resistor. Right? Current survey, what is the current, sir? It's called 4.61 amps. The current is in the direction 4.61 is the current. And what is the resistance, Norton resistance? 4.33. Right? And what is the load here? 3 ohm resistor. 3 ohm resistor. So 3 ohm resistor. So this is called current flowing into the load. Am I right? And then, so according to the current division rule, IL is equal to total current into, that is called 4.61 into opposite resistance by sum of the resistance. What is the opposite resistance? This is the opposite resistance. Why? Because this current is dividing into these two terminals. Okay, if the one more resistor here is there, understood? Right. सर इज द करंट हियर, करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द लोड, IL इज इक्वल टू टोटल करंट इनटू ऑपोजिट रेजिस्टर, दैट इज कॉल्ड 4.33 बाय सम ऑफ द रेजिस्टेंस 4.33 प्लस 3. सो व्हाट इज द करंट IL? And then you will get that current. If you're changing the low resistor is 5 ohms, so that means so substitute here you will get simply by replacing the low this one element that is called one number. Okay. Even the load changes, this current flowing the load is can be easily find by using this theorem. Same as Thevenin's theorem and Norton's theorem. This is the advantage of Thevenin's and Norton's theorem. Understood? So these are the different type of problems. So these are all questions, assignment. Okay. So many problems, 8 problems. Okay. All of do this. All of you take these problems fast. Thevenin's theorem and Norton's theorem. By using Thevenin's theorem, find RTH and VTH, and also similarly by using Norton's theorem, find RN and IN equivalent circuit. Find equivalent circuits of all these circuits. All of you take these circuits. Assignment questions are not Thevenin's and Norton's theorem. Assignment questions are not on Thevenin's and Norton's theorem. Theorems are over. Superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem. Only one more topic is left over in first unit. That is called transient response of series RL and RC circuit. If it is completed, that concept, and then first unit is over. And then we will go for second unit. Only one concept, transient response of series RL and RC circuit. All of you take these questions. Find the Thevenin's equivalent circuit and Norton's equivalent circuit. For these all problems. 8 problems. Seventeen series 621 absent 634 and 601 602 1906602 absent 603 604 605 606 196606 absent 7607 also absent 608 609 610 613 614 615 616 617 618
620 absent. 21.
621
622 absent. 623. 623 also absent. And then 624. 624 is also absent. 625. 625 is also absent. 626. Starting analysis is absent. 627. 627 also absent. 628.
628 present, sir.
630. Nothing. 630 also absent. 31. 32. 33. 34. 35. 635. 636. 37. 37. 637. 637. Nimala Kavya. 38. 638. 639.
639 present.
640. 41. 43.
43 present, sir.
44. 45. 46. 47. 647 absent. 648. 48 also absent. 649. 650.
650
51.
651
present, sir. 52. 352 present,
sir. 20
series 601. 602. 20 series 602 absent. 603. 604. 605. 605. Absent. 606. 606 also absent. 607. Absent. 608. 609. 610. 610. Absent. 611. 12. 613. 614. 615. 615 absent. 16. 616. 617. Okay. 19 series 602. Okay. 602. 19 series 638. What are you doing? Anyone? Tell me. What is the number? 19 series 631. Okay. Okay, I will see. Let's see today. So We'll discuss the remaining concept in next class.